Medyo matik pa. At tungkol dito, mga Those cases will be more rampant among the migrant people who came from rural areas and urban areas. On one occasion, a woman came to us asking for assistance. She and her children have been victims of violence from her husband, and they can no longer carry it. The husband, however, would not like to separate from her. The woman was advice to find a way of violence against women and children against her husband. The man was arrested and put in jail. After 2 days, the man asked for forgiveness and promised to reform. The woman forgave him and withdrew her complaint. The man even asked that they have more children. The woman agreed and soon was pregnant. However, she had miscarriage for an abortion of the 7th month, and since that time she never conceived. Heaven must have said, enough is enough. One day in October 1998, we incidentally prophet and outrage continues to. Early in the afternoon, we heard the prophet sound. Shortly afterwards, we were informed that a huge portion of the mountain had slid down the road and over the slope down below. A house at the roadside got buried in mud, rocks, and dirt. Our students completed the mountain and search and rescue operation. Members of the community joined in. And watchers were posted to be warning with other stewards. Rocks and mud poured down the mountain every now and then. It just became evident that rescue was no longer possible. The operation was now centered on recovering the bodies of the family. That included the mother, 3 children, and a cousin of the children. Later in the day, military personnel from the 2nd Infantry Division, based at Camp Kapiti in Tanan, arrived to assist. The last day, the name was recovered towards midnight. As the victims were recovered, they were washed and cleansed and then restaurant. They were then laid out on the classroom tables of the school. Candles were lighted and prayers offered. More morning services could not be immediately available because of the continuous rains and the severe and mild condition of the group. On the 3rd day, the court services provided by a good mayor that I arrived just in time. The mild weather had preserved the cold weather had preserved the bodies quite well, but the rising temperature was going to change their condition. The victims were finally buried a week after this disaster. The dining tables had been set up during the week. When enough money was generated from the country, the community said, it is now time to bury our dead. We continue to provide help and assistance to the needs of our capability. Our doors are open and we welcome people who need our help, and we welcome them with love, love and more love. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jules and Joseph Casano.